marks that the people of God bear, or can bear, is when the peace of God rests upon them. You see, we are marked people. We who are followers of Jesus are marked people. In the early days of our marriage, I used to work shift work. I always found the night shift the hardest. And about 2:30 in the morning, my eyes would want to close. It reminded me of a true story I once read about a soldier who was on guard duty. And early in the morning, he reported to his sergeant. And the sergeant said, "Did you have a good sleep last night on duty?" And he says, "What made you think I fell asleep, sergeant?" He says, "Look in the mirror." He looked in the mirror, and there on his forehead was a Mercedes-Benz imprint from the truck that he'd been bleeding on the steering wheel. Paul tells us that we should have a mark on us. The mark of Jesus. It singles us out as being followers of Jesus. And we've been thinking in these past weeks about dribbling the seed of the kingdom of God in our world, in every nook and cranny. The essence of this seed is it's generous, it's accepting of others, it's dispensing blessing, not cursing. It's doing extra without being asked. It's a positive influence. It acts like Jesus because we bear his mark. But today I want to think of how we best spread seed. We can do it singly, but there's a lot more power in it when it's done corporately. In partnership with God and each other, we should spread the seed into our world. And Paul, writing to this church at Philippi, says, is there any encouragement from belonging to Christ? Any comfort from his love? Any fellowship together in the Spirit? Are your hearts tender and compassionate? And to this point, you're all going, And then Paul says, make me truly happy by agreeing wholeheartedly with each other, loving one another, and working together with one mind and purpose. It's about kingdom life together. Together as a group of people, we can be far more effective in imparting the kingdom of God's seed than we can singly. And we agree with the message, one heart and purpose, one mind and purpose. He says, work together, one mind and purpose. Then he says, love one another. Work together. Well, firstly, love one another. And that means love everybody in the fellowship. That's easy, isn't it? Well, as that very famous fellow who's written such a lot of stuff, Anonymous, said, to dwell above with the saints we love, that'd be grace and glory. But to live we below with the saints we know, that's another story. You see, to love one another means to overlook offense, to forgive readily. Henry Blackaby says, love is the biggest Christian discipline. We can think of all the other disciplines that go with being a follower of Jesus, to be generous with our time and talent and our money, to read God's word, to pray, to all the disciplines, to fast, all the disciplines we think of. We can do all of those things well, but he says, love is the discipline that matters most. And we who are marked out to be God's people are called to love one another. We also need to have, if we're going to share the kingdom seed well, one mind and purpose. And that's the reason that we have articulated as a church our values. We have five values here at Camberwell. Five biblical values, five kingdom values. But they're the glue that shapes us and says this is who we are as a congregation of God's people, as an outpost of heaven. This is how we're going to operate. We value prayer. We value introducing people to Jesus. We value community engagement. We value people development. We value a life of worship. Now, we could have had a lot more values that come out of God's Word. There's probably 50 or more that we could have taken as a church. We take these five because they describe who we are. And if we're going to work together, if we're going to honour Paul's words to the Philippian church, he says, work together with one mind and purpose. We're going to be agreed about the values. And the values drive our behaviour. Work together, one mind and purpose. The working together part is important too. We're a team. We're a community of faith. And we think of team together. Everyone achieves more. And as we love one another, as we rally around, when one part of the body hurts, the other supports it. When one part of the body rejoices, the others join in the rejoicing. In what the news called the miracle of Quick, Pennsylvania, 9 miners were trapped for 3 days, 90 metres underground in a water-filled mine shaft. And they decided early that they were going to live or die as a team. And with 13 degrees Celsius water that was sort of starting to come up and surround them, they were scared that they were going to die from hypothermia. So one of the guys interviewed afterwards, they all got out, but one of the guys afterwards said, when one would get cold, the other 8 would huddle around and warm them. And when another person got cold, they would gather around and warm them. And Harry Mayhew, one of the rescue miners, said, everybody had strong moments, but any certain time, maybe one guy got down and the rest pulled together. And that guy would get up. And maybe someone else would feel a little weaker. But he said it was a team effort. It's the only way it could be. And we're called to be team Camberwell. Donald Greatwood, in his excellent book, The Upside Down Kingdom, a book recommended to me some months ago by Ian Wallace, and I've enjoyed Cray Bill's incisive look at what it means to be a Christian community. He says the church is an assembly of people who have welcomed God's reign into their hearts and relationships. The church consists of citizens of the kingdom. It's the body of Christ composed of obedient disciples following in the way of Jesus. We can envision the church as a community of believers, the collective gathering of the people of God. It isn't a building, it isn't a sanctuary or a program. It's a visible community of those who live by kingdom values. That's who we are. We're living by kingdom values. We're an interdependent cluster of people. We influence one another. We need each other. We support each other. We challenge each other. We love each other. Paul says, make me truly happy by agreeing wholeheartedly with each other, loving one another, and working together with one mind and purpose. And so we, Team Camberwell, are called to work together. But there's another element in this verse. Not only are we to be together as a body of people, Team Camberwell, but we're to ensure we are together with God, following His plan. For example, we could agree together and work together to pour all our resources into building a wing on a hospital in Indonesia. And we may well succeed in doing so, but it may not be what God wants us to do. And so there's a sense in which we need to add another together into this word. And working together with one mind and purpose. Together with each other, and together with God. In fact, we should put God first, together with God, and then together with each other. The two togethers, together with God, together with each other. It's absolutely vital we hear from God and march to His throne. For the last 3.5 years, we've been exploring what we need to do with our property here at Camberwell. And we've been talking to architects, we've got draft drawings, we've done lots of things. We've even talked to headquarters. But we're not actually 100% sure what it is God is wanting us to do. And so I'm going to talk to you next week about this, but we want to ask for the month of March specific prayers for direction and clarity about our property needs. You see, we need to be together with God in what He's wanting us to do in terms of our work, and together with each other in marching forward. And the property isn't the mission. The property is only the place out of which we do the mission. And property schemes can be a real pill for churches when they focus on property and not doing the mission. The property only helps us to deliver God's mission. But we need this together thinking. Paul says, make me truly happy, agreeing wholeheartedly with each other, loving one another, and working together with one mind and purpose. Agree with values. Love each other even when folks would seem to be unholy. Forgive regularly. Working together with God and each other as marked out people, scattering kingdom seed in our world. And it will mean that for the sake of the kingdom, I'm prepared to demote some of my own personally held values. Good and wholesome though they may be, so that the greater good of the faith community can be served. Maybe for you this morning, God has been nudging you about that time for team Campbell. And you need to sign up for the team. To say, I'm in. And David Stetcher, if you just raise your hand, is the man to talk to if you want to talk about membership in Campbell Salvation Army. But we're all marked people. We're carrying the message out to the world. And we'll do it better as a team than we do simply. We'll be part of the team as we carry this great news of Jesus into our world.